information tonight about the shootout between a member of the Outlaws motorcycle gang and federal agents in Old Orchard Beach. First off, the medical examiner's office performed an autopsy on the body of Thomas Main. The cause of death? Multiple gunshot wounds. He was shot to death early yesterday morning by federal law enforcement officials as they tried to execute a search warrant at a home. He was one of 27 outlaws nationwide indicted by a federal grand jury. Continuing coverage tonight from News 8's Jim Keithley, live in the newsroom. Jim?
Well, Tracy, this affidavit gives some but not all of the details involving yesterday's shooting. At the heart of it all, a turf war involving two well-known motorcycle gangs, the Hells Angels and the Outlaws. An affidavit filed in federal court sheds light on some of the details surrounding the shooting outside this house at 5 Sandy Circle in Old Orchard Beach. Thomas Main, a member of the Outlaws motorcycle gang, lived here. He was one of 27 members of the American Outlaw Association indicted by a federal grand jury yesterday. Agents in 10 states served arrest warrants, but this one turned deadly. Agents arrived just before 6 a.m. Shots were fired from inside through a window. ATF agents fired back. In the next 20 minutes, agents using a bullhorn ordered anyone else inside the house to come out. Two women surrendered peacefully, but according to the affidavit, Kenneth Cretion put up a struggle, was hit with non-lethal ammunition, and then tasered twice. Jim Boutet owns Jim's Auto Parts right next door and described Thomas Main as a nice guy who bought several vehicles from him over the years.
You know, he'd come through with his four-wheeler and stuff. He's very friendly around here. You know, to the guys and stuff. You know, in the wintertime, he asked permission to use a snowmobile out back and stuff.
Prosecutors say Mame and another outlaw member, Michael Padini, staked out a Hell's Angel clubhouse in Canaan last year and shot and wounded a member there. Padini has been in jail since his arrest in November for allegedly selling drugs out of a Waterville bar. Plainclothes officers back on the scene in Old Orchard today as neighbors and police remain tight-lipped, many saying they fear retaliation if they speak out.
It isn't uncommon for them to look for revenge, and hopefully they don't choose the police or the other law enforcement agencies involved in that, but it's something to be considered.
Stepped-up police presence has been ordered. And at the same time as the shootout in Old Orchard Beach, another member of the Outlaws was apprehended without any fanfare at this second-floor apartment on Railroad Avenue in Springvale. Neighbors calling Thomas Benvey a nice guy, a great father who played with his kids. And there was a fourth Mainer who was arrested yesterday, Joseph Allman. He lives in Hollis but was apprehended in Mississippi where he's been working. Live in the newsroom, Jim Keithley, News 8.